What's up, guys, and welcome back to another video. Today's video is recap time for Scotland taking on the Irish that took place last night. What a good game of rugby it was. Good performance from the Irish. Definitely showed that they are back, that they are improving and developing and continuing the form that they started last year. As for Scotland, unfortunately, it wasn't their game. I was very disappointed in some of the performances from the Scots. They didn't capitalise on opportunities, which was frustrating. And I'll get more into that as we go on. But also refereeing, thought I'd start jumping to that. I thought Poyter had a shocking game, not just for Scotland, but for both ways. I mean, really, there was the decisions, the odd one for Ireland that didn't go their way, and obviously for Scotland. I thought it was shocking that he didn't pick up that forward pass earlier when Scotland almost scored that try. I mean, it was clear as day, in my opinion. And the TMO is literally telling Poyt, what about the forward pass? Let's go there. And he was more focused on seeing if the ball had been grounded or whatever it may be there. So I was irritated with him. I don't think he's a good ref. He's probably one of the worst, in my opinion. I was disappointed in that. But other than that, good game of rugby. I thought both teams really gave it their all. As for Scotland, going more into detail with them, I just thought that they didn't capitalise on opportunities, making silly errors, not being able to catch the ball from an up and under. I know the wind was blowing and the weather was not the greatest, but it's silly errors like that that cost you games. I mean, Conor Murray's try was a capitalise of a pass that just went too wayward, and Conor was there. You can't make mistakes like that, because teams like Ireland, England, South Africa, All Blacks will capitalise and destroy teams in moments like that. So it's important for them to really work on the discipline and the basic errors they need to work on, because that it's what cost them the game, in my opinion. I was talking to even my father about it. It's just sad. They were in the possession for so much time at one stage in the first half. They just couldn't capitalise. They had an opportunity for that kick out for the try, and then they decided to do a quick tap and go, which I thought was quite smart, something you don't see every day, so I was impressed with that. But then they go and lose the ball and didn't have the momentum to go on. If Scotland had capitalized on tries and opportunities, it would have been a totally different ball game. Comparing to last year's result, obviously Scotland were stronger last year than to what we saw last night, but I just thought that they just weren't gelling. And weren't capitalising again. Like I said, I thought Finn Russell was still impressive. I mean, his moment was genius, what he brought to the game. Just a lot of work. I thought when Blair came back on, then the Scots started moving forward, which I thought was good, but then they seemed to lose it. And I mean, he also did that miscatch, which was a simple one in my opinion. So a lot to work on. They need to go back to the drawing board and see what went wrong and how they can capitalize on these errors and work on it, because if they're wanting to improve, they need to really seriously consider this, because this competition's just going to get tougher. They beat Italy convincingly last weekend, lost it in the last 10 minutes in my opinion, but then this week they'll pretty much brought back down to earth, having a competitive team like Ireland going at them. So I thought from that point of view, it was disappointing, but it was a fair effort. They had their moments of brilliance, but they just need to work on capitalising and keeping the ball and scoring tries and scoring points when needed. I think that's what let them down. As for Ireland, I thought they were brilliant. Definite improvement from last weekend. And they looked strong, they looked pumped, they looked really fired up. And they were alert on all the errors that Scotland were making. Like I said, with Conor Murray, that interception kind of thing, or steal of the ball, I thought was brilliant. He was quick and ready. Great try. Stockdale looked back and strong again, which I was glad to see. Keith Earls, another great legend of the game, also looking good. Rory Best was also alert and looking strong. Peter O'Mahony, I mean, that guy is just bloody brilliant. I mean, the amount of times he got the ball back was outstanding, and what he did on that field is brilliant. He really is a gem for Irish rugby, and I think going in the World Cup, just seeing the talent that the Irish have, it is immense. It's brilliant. So if they can keep them going, hopefully that they can do well and move forward. Johnny Sexton, unfortunately, off injured. That was a big loss for for Ireland, I think. Hopefully he gets a speedy recovery. I know Joe Schmidt said in the press that he reckons that it's going to be a speedy recovery, so I hope so, that he's back and ready. I think, yeah, we got a break this weekend, so hopefully he'll be back in time and make it. But I thought Joe Carberry did pretty well as a replacement. Not too bad. Must have been nerve-wracking filling the shoes for the man like Johnny Sexton. But I thought fair effort from him. Got points over when needed. But yeah, big loss for Ireland not having Johnny, but hopefully he gets a speedy recovery. But as for the squad, I thought they played strong, solid, capitalising on, like I said, the mistakes from Scotland. And like I said, the refereeing to me was shocking. But overall, I thought an impressive performance from Ireland. And I think they can take this going forward with a lot more confidence and really continue to grow from strength to strength and take this result as a positive. Forget about the English loss and move forward and take on the new opportunities that come with them. I mean, they got Wales, which is going to be one heck of a contest. I think Italy's up next. And then you still got France, who, after watching the England game just now, really looking nowhere. So they can capitalize on getting points. That will be important. They didn't get a bonus point, which is a bit of a pity for Ireland, because I think they would have been good to just have that extra bonus. But and also Scotland didn't get theirs. They're losing bonus points, so that was missed out on opportunities there. But hopefully we can see an improvement from Scotland as they go forward, because again, it's not going to be an easy campaign, but they could pick up a victory over France. The rate they're going, it's not looking good, but Wales and England are going to be really, really tough. So I'm excited for those games. I think it's going to be absolutely epic. Scotland frustrated me. There was opportunities and they didn't capitalize, and I thought that was poor. But the defense from the Irish was brilliant, and the attacking was even more impressive. If we look at some of the stats from the game, obviously Conor Murray getting his try, Jacob Stockdale, as well as Keith Earls, Sam Johnson getting the only try for the Scots. So 3-1. 100% kicking rate for Laidlaw, which is good. I think he should have kicked a little bit more so they could get more points on the board, but unfortunately missed opportunities for them. Their meters run 388 versus 365, very similar there. If we look at possession, 59% to Ireland and 55% in territory. So pretty much the dominance, the stats actually worked to the result, which was interesting. First half was 49%, so it was pretty even on possession. And then, unfortunately, second half, 33-67. Scotland just were just down and out. Clean breaks, 7 versus 10. To the Irish, 23 defenders beating to 26 to Ireland again. 7 offloads versus 2. So, yeah, interesting stats. Turnovers conceded, 16 from Ireland, 14 from Scotland. So Scotland definitely had the opportunities. It's just all about capitalising and getting stronger and making points where you can go. Other than that, there's potential there. They just need to work on it. Defending wise, 87% tackling. They made 202 tackles. Of those, 176 were successful. That's not bad at all. And then 156 tackles. This was 133 that was successful. So 85% for Ireland there. Discipline, 7 penalties conceded from the Scots and 7 for Ireland. Pretty low, which is impressive. But overall, needing a stronger performance from Scotland, and hopefully Ireland can go from strength to strength here so that they can keep their hopes alive of maybe getting second place, or if possible winning. It's going to be tough because England are looking really strong at this side, but anything is possible. It's still early days. It's only round 2 of the Six Nations tournament, but what a weekend, what a game. But I'm hoping to see some improvement. I want to see that fire from Scotland. They have the potential, but they need to work on discipline and their basic rugby skills. As for Ireland, I hope they go from strength to strength and continue their great form, because they're an absolutely fantastic team who really are brilliant at what they do, and I really hope that they can bounce back and prove to the rugby world that they are still contenders for the World Cup and still contenders maybe for the Six Nations. You never know. So that's going to do it for today's video, guys. Hope you enjoyed it. If you did, be sure to hit that thumbs up button. If you haven't already, make sure you are subscribed with the bell notifications on so you never miss another upload. Thanks so much for watching. Have a great week. Stay safe and never give up. Cheers.